Okay. All right, honey.
There, we can see you now.
Okay, I'm gonna shut it down.
Good.
Thanks, honey. Sorry to bother you.
All right, we gotta... Sorry, guys. Can you guys see us still?
Yeah, you're sideways.
Sideways?
Yes.
Yeah, you turn sideways.
I can't see you guys anymore.
Everybody is sideways now.
Okay.
Does that work?
See?
Where did you go?
Perfect. Perfect.
All right, I'm going to mute everybody except for Tyler so we can start, okay?
Okay. Yeah. Mwah. Love you.
Love you. Love you, guys.
Seventeen years ago, these two amazing people caught each other's attention. They met, they fell in love, and they've been sharing their lives and families, their hopes and their dreams ever since. They've been each other's witnesses and mirrors, cheerleaders and confidant. They've been each other's best friend. Which brings us to this moment, Saturday, July 11th, 2020. What we are celebrating today is not really the beginning of a marriage, but of a marriage already in progress. It's simply a continuation of what's already underway. So I'd like you to look at one another and remember this moment. This moment is one of millions of moments that have led up to this. Like that moment right there. This beautiful connection between the two of you. It's evident to everyone that meets you. They have contributed to your family and your future. This particular moment this morning is a culmination of millions of them over the last 17 years, and it's also a promise, a hint of the millions to come. So with that said, as you face each other, I'd like to invite you to share a few words about the other person. So let's start with Aisha.
And I just wanted to say, I actually 17 years ago started with a broken promise, and that was to myself. I didn't realize this was gonna happen. I realized I had said to myself, I promised I would never be in a relationship and that I would never have kids. And that was 17 years ago, but that was the best promise I ever broke. Because I have you, and you gave me one of the best gifts in the world, which is Matt. He's the most amazing kid in the world. And the thing is, like, what's weird is when I look at you and I look in the mirror, I don't see what I see in the mirror. When I see myself through your eyes, it's the most amazing woman in the world, and I can't thank you enough. I just promise, you know, you've seen my spectacular tantrums. It's not going to be easy. but I do promise to be loyal and to love you and just to keep having adventures and to have fun with you and Matt for the rest of my life.
Oh my God. What? What's that? Guys, they're getting married. They are getting married. Can you stop with the noise just a little second? They're here.
Me and Aisha are getting married right now online.
We have a whole new wedding.
We're sorry. Can you just keep it like? Thank you.
1 second. Just give me a second. Oh my God.
Yeah,
this is they've cut off the leaf blower.
Okay.
All right. Mine's written, so I'm sorry, babe.
That's okay.
I love you, and you give me your hands. You're my best friend, and we're getting married today after 17 years. And you know, when I saw you that day on the beach, it just did you were out of range. So, it's amazing when I look at myself now because of you. I love you. I don't think I'd be who I was if I didn't meet you, so. Just stick with me, babe. All right?
Yeah.
And I love you. I'll be there forever. All right.
A little too soon?
No, vows, that's good.
Hold on, I'm not there, Mama. Okay. So, Tears and Leaf Blowers, a 2020 wedding. Ladies and gentlemen, with their intentions set, their partnership clear, and their future very full, it is my honor to say, Dan and Aisha, with the power vested in me by the internet, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss each other to make it official.
Yay. If I work my hands at work, oh, would you still love me? Answer me, babe. Yes, I will. I'll put you above me. If Miller were my trade, I'd a mill wheel and grind name. Would you miss your color box? Oh, you soft you shine. Save my love through loneliness. Save my love through sorrow. I'll give you my own. Come give me your tomorrow.
Phone number.
Well, we were at Fire Island with my roommate, and he told Dan, he's a carpenter at the installing a hot tub the whole time I was there. And he told Dan, he's like, you better get her number. And I saw him and my roommate threatened me. He's like, you better get his number if he doesn't get yours. So Dan comes in with this little wood chip.
Wait, last day on the job.
Yeah.
I was leaving the job.
And then he
now
comes
or
in.
Now or never.
And yeah. Then he gives me this wood chip because he's a carpenter. He had written in pencil. He asked me if I wanted to see him again. And
I had two wood chips. My number on one.
Yeah, yes. But he was just like, I said, sure, let's meet up. And then he goes, okay, great. I'm like, did you want my number? And he goes, sure. So he's shaking so hard, he had to slam the wood chip onto the table to stop the
shaking.
That
was embarrassing, right? My hand was shaking. Like the guy I'm working with behind me, he's like, oh my God, he's like, I'm more nervous than you. And he's like walking in circles. He's like, what are you gonna do? Tick tock, tick tock. I had two empty glasses of water that she gave me. So I'm like, I'm bringing in the empty glasses. I'm gonna be nice. And I was, excuse my friend, shitting in my pants because I didn't want rejection. And she gave me her number and I was shaking so bad, I slammed it onto the table and wrote her number cool style. I could write it without shaking. And then I walked out and I went up on the boardwalk. Must have been a sign because the board flipped up and smacked me in the hand. I'm like, I got the number. I stepped on the boardwalk and let loose, shot up at me and broke my pinky. I was like, oh my God.
Worth it.
Worth it. It was so worth it. Got the number.